Sunita ensured her son Pankaj had a big, fat Indian wedding. For many months, Hemata's daughter-in-law Pallavi took good care of her. Pallavi, please make me a cup of tea.
Right away, Mom.
Hemlata was very happy to see this. Some days later, her son Pankaj went off to the city for work, and Pallavi's behavior had completely changed. Pallavi, please make me a cup of tea.
Listen, Mom, I have too many chores to do. If you want tea, make it yourself.
Hemlata was not impressed with her daughter-in-law's attitude. Pallavi wouldn't even serve Hemlata her food on time. Then Hemlata decided that she would teach Pallavi a lesson. Hemlata said to Pallavi, "Dear, I am going on a pilgrimage to the temple. I'll be back in a few months.
It would be better if you don't come back at all."
Saying this, Hemlata took her bag and left with her sister, Swarnalata. Now alone at home, Pallavi was very happy. Some months went by and Swarnalata returned home alone.
Pallavi, your mother-in-law is no more. She passed away while we were still on our way to the temple.
What? Mom! Mom!
Pallavi cried a lot and pretended to be very upset. Once all the funeral rituals were over, Pallavi was happy with her husband. One day, Pallavi was alone at home when she saw a spirit. The next day, Hemlata appeared in the form of a ghost in front of Pallavi. Pallavi screamed in fright and lost her consciousness. Then for the next few nights, Hemlata would continue to scare Pallavi dressed as a ghost. One night, when Pallavi was alone in the kitchen, Hemlata once again appeared to scare her.
Pankaj! Pankaj!
Pankaj ran to check up on his wife, only to find his mother there too.
Pankaj, I am still alive. I wanted to teach Pallavi a lesson, so I pretended to die and haunt her as a ghost.
Teach her a lesson? But why?
Pallavi, would you like to tell him everything? Or should I?
After you left for the city, I behaved very badly with your mother. So much so that she was forced to go on a pilgrimage.
No, I did not expect this from you. Mom, I apologize to you for my wife's behavior.
Thanks to Hemlata's act, Pankaj was able to see his wife's other side. And Pallavi also learned a lesson that she shouldn't pretend to be nice because the truth always comes to light. This story begins 15 years ago when Girdhar and Vikram were very good friends.
Hey Vikram, my daughter is only 5 years old, but I am already so worried about her wedding.
Oh no,
she is still a child. You won't get it, brother. You have a son. I will have to start collecting money for her wedding from now.
My friend, Maithili is like a daughter to me. Instead of being friends, why don't we become family instead?
What do you mean?
I mean that I will get my son Gopal married to your daughter Maithili.
Girdhar hugged Vikram tightly. Now, 15 years later, both the kids had grown up. Girdhar had pampered Maithili so much that she became very chubby. Now, when Gopal and Maithili got married, Vikram and his wife Vimla were very worried because Maithili
was used to being lazy. She wouldn't do any physical activities. Listen, Maithili, please get some tea for your father-in-law.
Yes, mother-in-law.
Maithili was bringing the cup of tea, but she was walking so slowly that Vimla wondered what to do about that. That night, Vimla and Vikram were discussing. Listen, Maithili has a wonderful personality, but her body is so very lazy.
Yes, even I was wondering what to do about that.
Don't worry about it. I have a good idea. The next day, Vimla called for Maithili. Maithili? Listen, Maithili.
Yes, mother-in-law.
We have a tradition in our house. When a new bride comes home, she takes rounds of the temple every day for whole 6 months. It brings a lot of joy and also happiness.
Sure, mother-in-law. When do I have to start this?
Today. Maithili went to the temple after being told to do so by Vimla. Since she wasn't very active, she was tired by the time she reached the temple. Maithili rested for some time and then started taking rounds of the temple.
Oh dear, I have only finished 3 rounds so far. There are 4 more to go.
Somehow Maithili managed to complete 7 rounds and then she went back home. The next day Maithili went back to the temple and took 7 rounds of it. After a few days, Maithili was able to reach the temple without panting at all, and she did her rounds easily. Vikram and Vimla were very happy to see this. In just 2 months, Maithili started losing weight. She wasn't lazy like before.
Maithili, please, can you bring me my glasses?
Go, father-in-law.
Oh, wow. That was really quick.
Maithili herself was liking her new active lifestyle. She continued to do her temple rounds. And then, 6 months later, her entire body had changed completely. She wasn't chubby anymore. She had become very, very fit. Even Girdhar was shocked to see Maithili like this. He spoke to Vimla about it.
I must say, you really did some good magic out there. But how did that happen?
All thanks to the goddess who lives in our village temple. It is her blessing. Glory to the goddess.
Glory to the goddess.
Maithili's life changed because she had lost weight. That was possible because she started walking so much. But the real credit goes to Vimla, who used her wisdom to help Maithili in getting fit from being chubby. This story teaches us that being overweight is really dangerous. It makes us very lazy and inactive.